Is this Quaily Plains? Cloud Retainer, why did you bring us here?
Ganyu is of course familiar with the name Guizhong, but have you ever heard of her? Guizhong is another name of Agentis, the god of dust. She was extroverted in nature and adored social gatherings and inventions alike. Long ago, this region was yet a prosperous assembly. Guizhong often invited her friends to visit her home, reserving for us seats around the largest stone table. Seagazer would always bring out his latest treasure and place it upon the table. Ah, he could be quite the braggart. Though usually a mild-mannered fellow, when it came to those collectibles he was so fond of, he always loved to show them off.
Paimon remembers that name. So that's what Seagazer was like.
He was an old friend and a former rival. One has many memories of him. Once he had brought out the treasure, it would predictably become the center of attention. Neither Guizhong nor one was content to let him just steal the spotlight. So we would then also present our proudest mechanical creations. As Adepti, we were each gifted in our own ways, and naturally proud of our accomplishments in our respective fields of expertise. As a result, one often quarreled with Seagazer. His treasures were not even of his own making. He just used his exploration skills to dig them out of the ground. How, pray tell, could he compare to me, when every single one of one's accomplishments were crafted by one's own hand?
Cloud Retainer, you are getting competitive again.
One digresses. Regardless, every time an argument occurred, Guizhong would come over to watch us during our mutual lambastics. On some occasions, she would join in, and on others, she'd take one of us by the limb and start uttering the most ridiculous nonsense.
What kind of nonsense?
No kind of nonsense were we spared. Sometimes she would brazenly opine, "Ah, why argue between yourselves when neither of you could ever hope to beat me?" Other times she would make unsolicited suggestions, such as, "Once you two are done arguing, let's go to the foot of the mountain and grill some meat." She always sought to make everyone happy, and one must say, she had quite the gift for it. No matter what nonsense she said, one never felt bothered or offended. It also helped that she never referred to one as that illuminated bird or lady bird.
You... come on, get over yourself!
Anyway, just as our impassioned arguments would reach the apex of acrimony, Marchosius would bring his delectable dishes to the table. Who would dare snub the stove god and his wondrous creations? At the sight of him, we would all immediately drop the argument and prepare the table for a night of feasting and drinking. Back then, one was always bothered by how the cups Rex Lapis brought were always too square for one's taste. Can you see yourselves ever enjoying a drink from a square cup? Precisely. So, as you can see, even one as great as Rex Lapis was not immune to making the occasional blunder. Even one could never find fault with Marchosius's cooking. As we ate, Guizhong would continue to find topics for conversation, filling the table with humor and laughter. Each of those old fossils had their character flaws and points of obstinacy. So why was it that whenever we dined together, we always had a marvelous time? We would drink together from a spot high in the mountains, until the moon set and the sun rose, and only then would the banquet finally come to an end. Streetwood Rambler would often remain to admire the flowers with Guizhong before returning to her own abode. The glazed lilies were far more abundant back then. Entire fields of them would appear to the eye as a veritable sea of flowers.
Streetwood Rambler?
That would be Ping. You probably know her as Madam Ping.
Oh, okay. Wait, this is a lovely story and everything, but didn't we come here to find that Adeptus from Mr. Dvorak's story? Or are you saying that it was Guizhong? Didn't she, already,
Alas, long has one avoided this place for precisely that reason. The sights here are a reminder of a time long gone, and evoke much sorrow. One should have guessed that you would disrupt one's poignant moment of mourning with your incessant questioning. No matter, one will share the whole story with you now. In times gone by, one quarreled oft with Guizhong concerning mechanical principles. We each had our ideals, and neither would yield. Under the pretext of a social gathering, one invited the impartial Rex Lapis to judge the quality of our creations. But Rex Lapis declared that Guizhong's obscuro vulpus mechanism was superior. Though one was too proud to acknowledge it, in one's heart, one knew that Guizhong was indeed the superior talent in the mechanical arts. As for the story between Guizhong and Streetwood Rambler, that begins with a certain bell. In Guizhong's opinion, while mechanisms were no substitute for human composers, they were yet capable of producing simple but fine melodies. But Streetwood Rambler believed music to be an expression of the soul, an emotional enterprise that could never hope to be replicated by machinery. They argued endlessly, until one asked Rex Lapis to intercede. He confiscated the bell and designated it for ceremonial use. Thereafter, one would often find them convening in the mountains, discussing music, mechanics, and all the affairs of the mortal world. But these good times were not to last. War broke out between the gods, and soon engulfed the Guili Plains. Guizhong was overpowered by the enemy, and fell in battle. When Streetwood Rambler and I arrived at the scene at long last, all that remained among the ruins was her lifeless body. After this, at Streetwood Rambler's request, Rex Lapis granted her the cleansing bell for safekeeping. To honor our friend's memory, one made a few finishing touches to her ballistic device. Many lantern rites have passed since then, many greetings and goodbyes. Upon what do you gaze? The Guili Plains?
No, it's everything. We think of human life as like a lantern that's lit 1 minute and extinguished the next. But are we Adepti so different? Perhaps as dust settles after a storm, we too must one day return to the world below.
One has always been austere and private by nature, and has never relished socializing.
And you seem pretty chatty.
Just because one is not ignorant of social graces does not mean one is fond of them. One is perfectly capable of partaking in conversation despite being introverted. But in the end, one is nothing like Streetwood Rambler. She is dauntless but thoughtful, not to mention eloquent and wise. Moreover, her friendship with Guizhong was far greater than one's own. Back when they were rivals, they would often compete against one another in the realm of musical composition. That cleansing bell was one of Guizhong's proudest works, having the ability to both compose and perform.
Wait, that's weird. Didn't Madame Ping say she pestered an old friend for that bell? And she also said something about being a vain beauty when she was young or something.
Street word rambler, a vain beauty. My foot. That bell has a sad history. Clearly, she refrained from sharing with you the truth of its origins, since the right time had not yet come. As for her old friend, who else could it be? As soon as Streetward Rambler heard that a certain Zhang Li wished to borrow the bell, she realized that the man was none other than Rex Lapis, and that he had made an enormous decision. After all, we all have known each other for several millennia. Some things between us are implicitly understood.
Whoa! So they were talking in secret code? Oh, Paimon did not see that one coming.
Enough of your intrusions. Where was one up to? Ah, yes. One remembers now. The cleansing bell is powered by a mechanical art, and can be used to great effect as an accompanying instrument. After the passing of its creator, it was used on numerous occasions during rites of parting. But Streetward Rambler did not acquire it from Rex Lapis for the purpose of producing further funerary tunes. No. Each time she rang it, it was to play the tune that Guizhong composed on it. The two once clashed over their beliefs about the meaning of music. Who would have thought that with Guizhong's passing and Streetward Rambler's mourning, two tunes composed in discord would eventually become one harmonious composition? Once upon a time, Streetward Rambler also loved gatherings, liquor, and music. But after Guizhong passed, she preferred her own company. She could often be found sitting alone at a mountain summit, contemplating and reminiscing with her zither. The music would go from mournful to soothing to impassioned. Many years passed before she finally composed a melody to her satisfaction. In celebration, she played the tune to the clouds. Regrettably, one has only ever heard her play that tune once. Which brings one back to the matter you've been investigating. Perhaps it was during that performance that the ancestor of your Fontaine friend fell into the water and was saved by Streetward Rambler.
But if she was so happy with the melody, why would she only play it once?
One was also greatly perplexed by this. After suppressing one's curiosity for a long while, one finally approached her and asked why she would retire the tune after having spent so long on it. In response, she said, "Though the strings that played that melody survive, the one who inspired it is gone. Tell me, Cloud Retainer, when the one attuned to my soul is no longer here, who else could hope to understand this tune?"
Aww, poor Madame Ping.
I just remember being taken care of by you when I was young. Once the Archon War came to an end, I stayed behind in Liyue Harbor to honor my contract. Although I met Guizhong a few times, I never knew anything of this particular story.
Guizhong was quite the visionary, but tragically passed before her time. Her manuscripts still lie unfinished in the realm of clouds. Blank pages give one cause for contemplation on what might have been. Had you not decided to search for that mystery Adeptus, perhaps these stories too would have been lost to the sands of time. As of now, you know the truth. That the Adeptus who rescued the drowning man was none other than Streetwood Rambler. Do you intend to discuss this with her?
Do you mean Ping might find the topic too distressing?
Precisely. The passing of our old friend is a heavy topic that both of us are usually careful to avoid.
If I may be so bold, Cloud Retainer, could it be that this is just your own personal opinion?
Oh? How so?
I've been in Leo Harbor for quite a long time now, and I've witnessed many farewells along the way. So I, too, am well acquainted with the pain of the passing of a loved one. But this doesn't bring the city or its people to a standstill. They have to keep moving forward. Someone as perceptive and wise as Ping will surely have come to understand and embrace this. Though these immortal mountains have lost an Adeptus, the harbor of mortals has gained a wise elder. No loss can ever be undone, but there is always much that can still be gained. Ping has helped countless people, and will guide many others in the years to come. And all to whom she extends a helping hand become her. Though it is heartbreaking to lose a kindred spirit, life goes on, because there are new friends waiting for you further down the road.
We even asked Madame Ping what she thought about adding a music festival to this year's Lantern Rite. Oh, when we get back, why don't we just ask her if she'd like to perform? Maybe we can even get her up on stage.
You youngsters and your imaginations.
Why don't you come with us? It's been a long time since you last spoke with Ping. And Leoa Harbor is always decorated so beautifully during the festival period.
Is not every lantern rite the same in this regard? Were there ever anything new to discuss, one in Ping could meet any day of the year.
I disagree. Each new day and each new year is different from those that have come before.
The edibles she brought this time were indeed quite delectable. Very well. Then one will be off. If the other old fossils have sneaked away into the city to amuse themselves, one shall soon find out.
All right. We should be getting back to the harbor as well. We don't want to keep her waiting. Once the Gweili Assembly, now the Gweili Plains. Say, if we planted flowers there, and cared for them carefully enough, do you think that one day we'd be able to recreate the Sea of Glaze Lilies?
Allow one to take back one's praise from a moment prior. You are still far too given to flights of fancy, child.
What? Cloud Retainer?
One observed that you were making no effort to leave, and returned to chasten and hasten you. This time, one is departing in earnest.